Hello, everybody, and welcome to another live broadcast. Just give me a moment to share this link and we'll be able to get started for today. Now, for today's video, I'm actually going to be working on the side view, which is one of the more difficult views to do in an object turnaround, especially when it's a vehicle design. So you're going to see me take a pirate ship design that I actually just recently completed and attempt to turn this sideways and essentially, start working on the full rotation for this image. So generally, this is a pretty technical thing. It does require quite a bit of time to do it. This initial concept art that you're going to see me using actually took close to 10 hours to complete, just the line work itself. This is by no means a simple image. However, you learn a lot, and it's a great exercise to improve your perspective skills in general. Almost done sharing this, guys. I may actually end up losing my voice during the stream. My voice has, I've been doing a lot of audio recording today, trying to get some videos done ahead of time so that I can have them on the queue. But a lot of that involved obviously a lot of extra work. So, past 2 days I've been working nonstop. So you'll find that I should be able to get to see one of my vehicle turnarounds live. Now I have flattened out this image completely because if I don't do that, then I can definitely run into quite a few issues. So this is the ship design that I came up with. So it's a pirate ship. The only thing I haven't added yet is actually the flag, just because I'm more concerned about the rest of it, trying to get the rest of it to work. So as you can see, there's a lot of information, a lot of detail in this image. It's by no means a simple image to turn, but that's essentially what I'm going to attempt to do in today's video. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to temporarily turn this onto a multiply layer and create a blank layer to put below it. But I can fill it with white. I'm just going to do a really quick test to make sure it is actually, in fact, transparent. Yes, it is perfect. So I'm going to lock this. Actually, I'm going to change the transparency first. And I'm just going to lock that for now. And I don't want to touch that white background either, otherwise, I won't be able to see my line art. So generally, what I prefer to do is I prefer to figure out my rough structure first. So I'm just going to choose a random color here. Because essentially, I need some basic points here. So this basic framework just tells me roughly where everything lines up, and also shows me any mistakes, if there's any, in a perspective. Sorry, guys, I'm going to have to actually grab a drink of water, so I'm going to mute myself for a sec here and disconnect myself. I've just done so much audio recording today that my throat's... So keep also an eye out for future announcements, because I may have a important announcement to make on my channel. I don't want to divulge too much until I have full confirmation. I'm going to modify the structure a tiny bit, just so that it makes a little bit more sense as well. In the beginning stages, I tend to really rough out my stuff here. It's generally not, I find, advisable to go too detailed. I'm just trying to figure out where I'm going to add the basic information before I start adding too much. It's just a it makes it easier when you're trying to actually add the detail in if you have at least a basic of ideas as to where you have to put all the information. Just let me see if any of you guys left a comment. Yeah, Theo quotes are pretty fun, actually. They're super technical, which is why I really enjoy working on them. I'll go for a little bit longer, guys, and then I'm going to cut the stream. My throat is like really killing me. Okay, guys, I'm gonna call it a day. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon. So thank you and take care.